And Camille locked in for that 1v1 with the ability to split push and also a fair... Gragas is recalling, so this gank is on.
Comet of Legend comes in. King trying to get himself away, has already popped the flash. Star Surge gets the stun into the follow-up CC combo. King still walking away from this one, but not for long. The first blood goes to Redbird.
And just what you expect from an... To clear the waves is here they go.
There's your flash, your stun, your initiation, and the Hextech ultimatum to make sure there's no escape. Redbird now might pay for it with his own life. Gets the stun onto Shurnfire with the auto attack.
He might live.
Redbird has no summoner spells left. Shurnfire has flash and body slam. They just go for it here. Destiny also cutting him off.
Yep.
Redbird is the sacrificial cow, and Shurnfire cashes in.
Yeah, King doesn't quite get it.
There in the dead center of the river, putting a lot of spears into the Infernal Drake. It's going to be secured by the Dire Wolves, but now the fight breaks out. Cosmic Radiance down to keep King protected. Absolute keeping himself safe over the wall, but it's Shurnfire who's caught out by the rest of the wolves. By the rest of Team 1, excuse me, the Wolves nowhere in position to keep Shurnfire alive. Getting himself caught out a little bit here, has to flash away. Shurnfire popping his own flash now as well. Redbird, the one who is now standing alone. Pops the Alistar ultimate, trying to tank these guys as long as he can, but even through that ulti, 5v1 is not the kind of a fight you're going to be winning. They will trade that Alistar away for the mid-tier 1, though.
And Chippies may be caught.
Speaking of numbers advantages, the Star Surge comes down, the damage goes through, the stun on the Chippies, and 1, again, punishes Direwolves for not being fully aware.
That don't happen at all.
Turret still alive, many minions beating on it though. Absolute jumps over, tries to put himself in a good position to make sure they get this kill, and they will. The Hextech ultimatum makes sure he's going nowhere. Vert grabbing the killing spree on that one. 3-0-1 on this Camille. 80% Ragnarok, 4-land, trying to make sure he can secure this one. It's ultimately picked up by the Direwolves, but can they find anyone else? 4-land's gonna be locked down. There comes your Equalizer, able to secure one kill. Cosmic Radiance to keep them safe, but there's not really anything threatening their health to begin with. Vert grabs the...
Redbird is.
Redbird popping the ulti pretty early here. Marf trying to deal with Fantix in a 1v1 situation.
Oh,
Shurnfire forced to flash away. Destiny gonna be caught out. Can't keep himself alive with the Cosmic Radiance. It does not come down in time.
Oh, here they go.
4-land popping the Ragnarok. Looking to go in. Voice of Light finding the slow onto 2. Fantix trying to escape, but he's not gonna be able to do it. The double kill for Absolute. King looking to get away. No way out. The damage is there. And 1 wins the fight. A triple for Absolute.
Big kill
here, Redbird. Cast your heal or something. 4-land's very,
oh, no.
very low.
Oh,
they
no.
might not be able to do it. Redbird, get in there. You gotta face tank it.
Oh.
Okay, that was close.
Teleporting in, actually. I guess they just really want to trade here, Direwolves.
They'll potentially catch Vert. Wants to take the Blast Cone. Fantix reading him. Vert trying to escape. Not today. They'll shut him down, which is nice because that means he won't have the... Waiting for the stun. There we go. Wants to get the headbutt too. Absolute shows up. Explosive charge is armed and ready. And there you go. The damage is enough. Absolute's on a rampage. Static shift aside of Team 1.
But right,
now, the Direwolves catching out. Marf is a bad omen for these guys. Great stuff from Direwolves. Finally putting the shoe on the other foot. Catching the enemy solo laner out and punishing them away. But Redbird goes over the wall. He's got the headbutt, got the pulverize, got the stun. And he's even got Absolute there for the backup. They take down the Direwolf mid laner, and 4-land wants to go even further.
Redbird doing everything.
Oh no, not again. Fantix getting himself stunned up, but Cosmic Radiance is there in time, and Marf, actually the first pickup in this fight. This could be huge for the Direwolves. Redbird now into the back line, finding the stun onto Chippies. 4-land's wanting to run up as well. Ragnarok comes down. Absolute gonna be keeping himself safe. Shurnfire drops
winning.
Down. Absolute jumping away, but Fantix in hot pursuit, able to find the damage with the auto attack and the shutdown for Direwolf.
Oh, nothing.
This is it. This is the kind of play that either wins or loses you the game. And here we go. Team 1 looking to stop him here in the Baron Pit. 4v5. 4-land going to be forced off.
But Camille's going to end the game if they keep them busy.
Baron has been taken. They're just trying to stop the back. Shurnfire dropping nearly down to dead. Absolute, one more auto attack. Grabs him. Fantix
going
to be taken down next. Absolute needs one more. Manages to find him, but King's able to route him next. Marf gets the kill onto Fantix. Now King's looking to fight these guys both. He drops two. Only Chippies remains. The Nexus turret's now under pressure. One Baron buff left running on the side of Direwolves. A triple for Marf.
But it's 20 seconds by himself. Chippies, I don't think he has what it takes to try and hold this off. That desperation play from the side of the Direwolves might have just lost them everything.
Chippy's gonna be jumped on, he's taken down, and Team 1 will find their back-to-back victories against the Direwolves, and the representatives from the CB Law will move forward into the knockout stage.
With a big 2-0 on the day, a very much commendable performance and noticed improvement from the entire roster of Team 1 Esports. They go back to their roots, they pick the Tristana, they team fight, and They take apart Oceania's representatives in the Direwolves. That one's gotta hurt.
We talked at the beginning of our first game today, Rusty, about how these teams needed to adapt from game one, or from day one, excuse me, to day two, about what kind of weaknesses they were gonna shore up, about what kind of strengths they were gonna highlight. And team one, yes, they had a rough game against Cloud9 to start the day today, but their performances in